And electrostatic, so far we have talked about electrostatic force, and what we know about electrostatic force is that it depends on medium. How can we say? If you know that, we have discussed so far is the force between two charges kept at a separation of R is written in this way, correct? In this one, what is this? We said that it's epsilon naught. We said it's permittivity of free space. Permittivity of free space. Now this free space is what? Free space means is, if you remember, I told you either we can talk about vacuum or you can talk about air. Okay, but if it is some other medium, then how will be the charge? What is going to be the difference in that? So see that if another medium is there, suppose we say that this is Q1 and this is Q2. Okay, there is another medium and the separation between them is R. Then what happens to this force? We write this force as 1 by 4 pi epsilon, not epsilon naught, epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square. Okay, now what this epsilon is? This is permittivity of that medium. Okay, that is called permittivity of that medium. Now the question is, what is its value? Okay, what is its value? So to know this value, we are going to talk about another permittivity which we call as relative permittivity. Relative permittivity, which we write as ER or epsilon R. What is its value? It is actually the ratio of permittivity of medium to permittivity of free space. What is it? Relative permittivity is absolute permittivity of the medium by permittivity of free space, or epsilon is epsilon R epsilon naught. Okay, so it means this epsilon obviously will be more than epsilon naught. Okay, this epsilon will obviously be more than epsilon naught, right? So you remember that in some questions relative permittivity will be given. Epsilon naught value we already have. That's the way we can calculate the permittivity of the medium. But sometimes they will talk about dielectric constant. Dielectric constant, which we represent with K. And this K actually is relative permittivity only. What is K? Relative permittivity only. Are you able to understand? So right now we are going to talk about this relative permittivity and dielectric constant only. So first try and understand that. Right now I told you that epsilon value is obviously more than epsilon naught. Okay, that means in medium, when you are keeping it in a medium, this force definitely is going to decrease. So in what medium it is going to decrease and what medium it is not going to decrease, we are going to discuss. Okay, so first of all, let's see, if we are going to have medium, any other medium is there, then why the force is changing? That we need to look at. Okay, so different type of medium are there. Okay, some medium are there which can be polarized, some mediums are there which cannot be polarized. Okay, so we are going to talk about the dielectric constant, such kind of a medium which we can say is kind of an insulator. Okay, let's discuss first about that. Like how many types of material we have? We can say there's a conductor, okay, then we can have insulator, or we can have semiconductors. Okay, so what is this conductor? Conductor basically means is those kinds of substances in which we have the electrons which are relatively free. That means they are far away from the nucleus. Okay, they are far away from the nucleus. Let's say metal. All the metals, you can say that the outer shell electrons are at a considerable distance from the nucleus. So some of the electrons comes out on the surface, and those electrons can move throughout the copper or throughout the iron, you can say, aluminium, you can say, or silver, you can say. That's why we call them as conductors. Okay, because of the availability of free electrons. So once you are applying electric field across them, they will be moving according to that particular electric field. Okay. What are insulators? In insulators, all the electrons are tightly bound with the nucleus. So, electrons are not free. Okay. But when you are going to apply the electric field from outside, some of the electrons actually shift towards the electric field. Okay. What they do? They will shift towards the electric field. Because of the effect of external electric field, they move a little. But they are not free to move. Remember that? They are still bound. But tentatively, they move little from their own place. So, those particular metals or those particular material we call as dielectric. Okay. Dielectric basically is a part of insulator. Okay. Semiconductor means what? Semiconductor is in between conductor and insulator. In semiconductors also there are no free electrons, but free electrons can be generated relatively easily. Okay. In insulator it's very tough to make the free electrons. Okay. But in insulator, or rather in semiconductor, you can easily make free electrons. Okay. But still, the number of free electrons available in semiconductor is a lot less than that of conductors. That's why it comes in between the two, insulator and conductor. Okay, so let's come back to the force again, force in the medium. So the formula that we are going to write over here for the force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon q1 q2 by r square, or we will write the formula as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught k q1 q2 by r square. Okay, now what happens when we are talking about different kind of material? If you are going to keep the charge in those kind of material or medium, why the force is going to decrease, particularly the dielectric that we are talking. In conductors, the force doesn't decrease, it remains same. Okay, conductors do not change the medium, or rather the force. Force remains same. But in this dielectric medium, what happens? Now suppose that I take a medium which can be polarized. Okay, polarized means what? If you are going to put a positive charge into that, so negative charge of the medium will surround it. Suppose I take any medium which can be polarized, and I am keeping, let's say, Q1 charge in that medium. This is a medium. Okay, it's a positive charge. So what will happen? The medium which can be polarized, it's negative charge. Negative ions, or electrons you can say, are going to surround it. All the electrons will surround it. Okay, so what is the net force on this one due to all the electrons? It will be zero. Why? Because all the electrons are attracting it from all the directions. So, net force on this Q1 is zero. Right? No problem here. But if suppose that another charge Q2 I am going to bring in the same medium, what will happen? On this Q2 also there will be electrons surrounding. No doubt about that. There is no doubt about that. But on this one, if we look at, on this Q1, okay? And remember again, you are able to polarize it, but we are talking about a dielectric. So, as such, motion of these electrons is not possible from one place to another. Okay. So, now what happens is, this Q1 is surrounded with these electrons. Yes. Because of Q2, what will happen? This Q2 is applying force on Q1. Yes. So, this Q2 will also apply force on these electrons. Yes. So, what kind of force will be on these electrons due to Q2? This Q2 is going to attract. Right? But these electrons are not able to move because this is external, this is applying external field on these electrons. So, what will happen? These electrons will shift a little. What shift? More electrons will come on this side. Are you able to understand? Because of the force of Q2, some more electrons come to this side. So, here electrons are more and here electrons are less. So, now net force on Q1 is not zero. Right? But now if suppose we ask that what is the total force on Q1? Let's see what is happening. We know that Q2 is going to apply the force on Q1 same what it was applying earlier. Okay, F. But these negative charges now, because they are more this side as compared to this one. So net force of electrons on this Q1 will be in this direction. So what is the net force because of Q2 on Q1? It is same or less? Net force I am asking. Individually, if I ask what is the force of Q2 on Q1, it will be same only. Okay, it is not going to change because of the electrons. But the net force now, the net force we will say, force on Q2 due to Q1 minus force on Q1, sorry, here. Force on Q1 due to Q2, and here force on Q1 due to electrons. So this will be the net force. So because of this reason, the force is getting decreased. That's why we are writing the net force is what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught k Q1 Q2 by R square. Did you understand why this force gets decreased when you are keeping the charges in medium? Okay? So this is the theory behind it. Now let's check how and what kind of questions are asked in that. First you will see the basic type of question, and then we will build upon that. Now see the first type of question. Suppose here again 2 microcoulomb charge and 5 microcoulomb charge is there. Separation between them you can say is half a meter. Okay, and they are kept in air. What is the force applied by 2 on 5? Okay, force applied by 2 on 5. So that means force on 5. Force on 5 microcoulomb due to 2 microcoulomb. Okay, what it will be? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 microcoulomb into 5 microcoulomb by 1 by 2, 0.5 square. Now 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 9 into 10 to the power 9. This is 10. Microcoulomb means 10 to the power minus 6 to 10 to the power minus 6. That means 10 to the power minus 12 into 1 by 4. Okay, this 4 will go up. So 9, 4, 36 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 10. So what we are getting? 36 into 10 to the power minus 2 Newton, or 0.36 Newton. This is in air. Now if suppose I say, now we are going to keep it in a medium where K value is 3. Where K value is 3. Then this force how will be calculating? Same force of 2 microcoulomb on 5 microcoulomb. Okay? That's equal to now, what is the formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught k Q1 Q2 by R square. Right? Now you check here. This entire thing is same only, right? If I take this 1 by k over here. Now this thing is same as this one. Correct or not? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So this and this are same. So that means actually the force has become what? This F dash has become F by K. Correct? And K value is 3. So here we can write directly 36 into 10 to the power minus 2 by 3. That is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2 Newton. Correct or not correct? This is the simplest of questions. They ask this kind of question. Okay? Now we are going to build up on that. Now, what kind of questions can be asked? See, okay, see now, there are two charges, Q1 and Q2, okay, they are kept in air, and the separation between them is R. Okay, then the same charges Q1 and Q2 are kept in a medium of dielectric constant K. Okay, and the question is asked, what should be the separation? What should be the separation between two charges? Between two charges in the medium so that the force between two charges is equal to force in air at separation R. Okay, so here he is asking that what should be the separation x so that the force between these two is equal to the force when they are kept in the air at separation R. Okay, fine, we will find it. Easy question. So see then, what is the force in air? We know 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. Force in air. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. Right? Force in the medium. That's right then. Force in medium. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by x square. And here k. Right? K is the dielectric constant. Now it says that both are equal. Equate that. F in air equal to F in medium. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught K Q1 Q2 by X square. What we can cancel? Q1 Q2 gone. 1 by 4 pi epsilon gone. Okay, so what it is? R square equal to kx square. Right? So x is equal to what? R by root k. Okay, x is equal to R by root k. Is that clear? Or R square equal to kx square. Right? So now, on this concept only, we are going to build up and we are making one question. Now see how to find the forces again. Okay, let's see. Now suppose that here is charge Q1 and here is charge Q2. Okay, and let's assume that the separation between them is R, and from here to here, in this part, there is a medium of dielectric constant K, and up to distance T, there is a medium of K. After that, there is air. And the question is asking, find force exerted by Q1 on Q2. I mean, it's a combination now. Medium and air combination. So how to solve this? What we have to think is, equivalent of this medium, how much should be the separation air? Are you able to understand? Last question, we did the similar thing. Okay. Here, what is given to you? T. That means x value is given to you. In the last question, if you remember, we got something like this. R square equal to kx square, or R equal to x root k. Correct or not? In this one, x we were finding. Right? So here, x is given to us as t. It's already given. Remaining this distance is R minus t, we know. Okay. We want to convert this t into the equivalent distance in air. How much shall we write equivalent distance in air? So I would say this part, this t, I can write as, see here what I am going to write. In equivalent distance in terms of air, you can say R air is equal to x in medium into root k in medium. Correct or not? So this distance, if I am going to write in terms of air, what I will write, just see. This t, in place of this t, I can write this as t root k and remaining r minus t. This is q. Do you understand? R minus t is same only. This is air. But here what I did, I converted this medium separation into equivalent distance in air. Understood that from this one? Because x is t multiplied by root k will be equal to distance in air. Okay, so what I did over here, check. Now I am going to write the force in directly in air only, because this is also air now. Because this is equivalent to t root k in air. Okay, so what is the force now? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by this plus this r minus t plus t.